Hello everyone, welcome to our talk of uncertainty calibration, tree-based feature wear banning for individual uncertainty calibration. My name is Yunli Wang from the Alibaba Group. This is a joint work with the University of Alberta. In many machine learning applications, such as click-through rate prediction, we assume that each symbol is an observation under a different probability distribution. With the positive or negative observations, we want to not only predict which event is more likely to happen, but also make the prediction to be close to the true probability of the event. In these tasks, people usually take the positive or negative observations as the label to train a classification model. Unfortunately, the prediction of most classification models, such as logistic regression and deep neural networks, usually deviate from the true probability, either overestimated or underestimated. The uncertainty calibration focuses on measuring and reducing the gap between the predictions and the true probabilities. To better understand some basic concepts of uncertainty calibration, let's first look at how to measure the gap between the predictions and the true probabilities. To evaluate uncertainty calibration, we can define an error with the true probabilities, such as equation 1, which is named TCE in previous works. The TCE is short for true calibration error. Unfortunately, the true probability is unavailable in practice, so people usually use ECE to evaluate the calibration error approximately. Let's look at a simple example to better understand how to compute the TCE and ECE. We can assume 10 symbols with which the true probabilities are represented by true prob, and the observations are represented by feedback, and the predictions are represented by predicted CTR. According to equation 1, we can directly get the TCE in L2 norm is 0.9%. To compute the ECE, we should first sort the symbols with the predictions and divide the symbols into uniform mass bins. Each bin is a subset of the symbols. Uniform mass means each bin has the same symbol number. Then we can compute the PCE of each bin, and the ECE is the average of the PCEs. PCE is short for partition calibration error. Kumar et al. Proposed ECE sweep, which is a variant of ECE, replacing the uniform mass division with a new strategy. All of them ignore an intuition question. For a well-calibrated result, the PCE of each bin with enough symbols should be close to zero. But the ECE and ECE sweep only evaluate the calibration error from a certain perspective. So we propose the MVCE in equation 4 to mitigate this problem. Given a bin size, we randomly sort the symbols and divide them into the bins in uniform mass way. It means each bin has the same symbol number. Then we can compute an error like ECE. We do this progress r times and compute the mean error as the MVCE. In most real-world applications, we can't get the true probability, so we can't even evaluate the calibration matrix. So we design a simulation experiment where we directly assume the true probabilities and the predictions. Then we can compute the TCE and evaluate a calibration metric. We use the Monte Carlo method to estimate the bias of a calibration metric mu. The empirically estimated difference is given by equation 6, where m is the times we generate a set of samples from the assumed distribution, each set with random n samples. X represents the observations and H represents the predictions. Figure 1 shows the estimated difference of ECE, ECE sweep, and MVCE under various sample size n. We can see that MVCE achieves the best result, indicating that MVCE is a better metric for calibration error than ECE and ECE sweep. Now we have already learned about the concepts of PCE, ECE, MVCE, and the data bin or named partition. Then let's take a look at the existing calibration methods and our main work. Existing post-hoc calibration can be divided into three groups: parametric, nonparametric, and their hybrid. Scaling methods adopt a parametric function with a certain characteristic assumption, which is usually data efficient, but lacks theoretical guarantees. Binding methods divide the data samples into finite buckets, and then calibrate the samples in the bucket by its average prediction, which provides distribution-free theoretical guarantees but requires more data samples. Kumar et al. Propose a new method that combines plot scaling and histogram binding to balance the data efficiency and distribution-free theoretical guarantees. Although the widely used binding methods don't have distribution assumptions, we find the binding scheme of previous methods is too simple, limiting the calibration performance. In our work, we also consider the hybrid of binding and scaling, and further explores how to find the better schema. Previous work has proved that binding-based methods provide a theoretical bound for each bin, which is shown in equation 7. Although binding-based methods appear to be more general and have some theoretical guarantee, such a guarantee is only for specific partitions determined by the calibration method. In other words, there are only some bins will be well calibrated, but for perfect calibration, each bin with enough samples should be well calibrated. We think the existing binding strategy, which refers to the uniform mass or equal mass division with sorting, is too simple. Kumar et al. Also proved that there exist better partition schemes than uniform mass and equal mass methods with sorted samples, although they don't provide a method to find them. In the following, we will introduce feature-aware binding, which is more likely to find a better division scheme automatically. For traditional binding method, if we happen to put the samples with the same true probabilities into the same bin, the calibration result will be near perfect. This situation can be extended to a specific calibration function for the bin, not just constant function in traditional binding. But how to achieve this? An intuition is the best pattern between the prediction on X and the expectation of Y would have different widespread patterns related to X that can be captured by machine learning methods. Therefore, we propose a feature-aware binding framework to learn which samples belong to a best pattern. It employs a model M, which takes the features X as input and optimizes the MVCE. Specifically, we employ a linear function as the best pattern to achieve individual calibration. In other words, we would like to find samples that have the same SUD. SUD is the short for simple underestimated degree. Similarly, we can also define PUD corresponding to partition instead of simple. Besides the true probability, order accuracy, often measured by the AUC, is also important to various applications, such as computation or advertising. Traditional methods often apply non-strictly or strictly monotonic calibrators, assuming that the base classifier F can predict the correct order. However, this assumption appears too strong and restricts the power of the calibrator. In our work, we lift such constraint and our MBCT may be non-monotonic. Let's take a look at the MBCT overview from Figure 4 and review the main points of our method just mentioned. We adopt a tree to learn a division schema which optimizes the MVC loss. There are three stopping conditions for growing one tree. The first is the node reaches the maximum deep set as a hyperparameter. The second is the simples in the node is less than beta, which is heuristically estimated by the theoretical bound in equation file. The last is the local loss raises after splitting and calibrating the node. Here, the local loss refers to the loss on the subset corresponding to the node to be divided and calibrated. We don't adopt global loss because it will greatly increase the complexity for MBCT. We conduct both offline and online experiments to verify the effectiveness of our method and the impact on the real-world application. For the offline experiment, we dumped the impression and click logs from our commercial deployed online display advertising system, and we call our industrial dataset CACTRDC. In addition, we test our method on two public datasets, showing the generality of our method. This table presents the statistics of these datasets. We compare our MBCT model with the following state-of-the-art models in previous studies: plot scaling, beta calibration, histogram binning, S-tonic regression, and the combination of scaling and binning. Table 1 presents the main results of our approach on three datasets. We see that MBCT consistently outperformed the original base predictor and all the baseline calibration methods in terms of both MVC and AUC metrics, which indicates that our method can bring improvements on both calibration and order accuracy, and is generalizable to different datasets. In Table 1, we simply set the bin size of MVC and ECE to the minimum bin size during training. The MVC score under different bin sets is also a curious question, and we show the trend in Figure 5. We see that MBCT consistently outperforms the baselines on MVC and all bin numbers, which further illustrates the effectiveness of our method. We also analyze the effect of training losses. We compare our MVC loss with traditional ECE and ECE sweep losses in Figure 6. We see that using MVC as the training loss consistently outperforms ECE and ECE sweep on the three datasets, which shows that it's beneficial to consider the average PCEs from different perspectives during training. We further conduct an analysis to show whether MBCT puts simples with similar bias patterns for F into the same bin. We randomly select 5 bins of MBCT and histogram binning, and divide each bin into 4 subgroups. Each bin of MBCT is corresponding to a leaf node. Figure 7 shows the PUD of these subgroups. It appears that the subgroups of MBCT is closer to 1, which implies that MBCT learns better relationships between the inputs and the bias pattern of F than naive binning methods. To the best of our knowledge, previous work has not applied their calibration methods to real-world applications, it's important to test whether calibration can improve performance in the real world. We deploy MBCT to calibrate the click-through rate for an online advertising system and conduct an online A/B test for 15 days. We use click-through rate and the effective cost per mile to evaluate the models, which are the key performance metrics. The online experiment results is shown in Table 2. These improvements are significant for an online advertising system, demonstrating great business value. Finally, we would like to summarize again our work and main contributions. We propose MBCT, a novel calibration method that combines binding and scaling methods. It improves the binding scheme by adopting multiple boosting trees and learning the bias pattern of the predictor with data. We propose a MVCE metric for calibration evaluation. It evaluates the calibration error from multiple perspectives and is closer to the theoretical value than previous metrics. We construct a dataset of click-through rate prediction with real industrial logs. It fertilizes the research of uncertainty calibration and click-through rate prediction. We conduct comprehensive experiments to verify the effectiveness of our method and metric. We further conduct online experiments in a real-world application to verify the impact on uncertainty calibration. Results show great commercial value of uncertainty calibration and our proposed method. Thanks for your listening.